Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the Angular TreeView component using a template. Looking at this example, you can see the TreeView component nodes are customized based on their levels. Here, icons and images were added to the tree nodes, and the expand and collapse icons were also customized. Let's see how to customize the TreeView nodes in an existing Angular TreeView application. I open an Angular application, where I have added the TreeView component with the fields property. I have bound a self-referential data source with these fields. If you want to know how to get started and bind self-referential data to the Angular TreeView component, watch the video link provided in the card above. I have imported the TreeView component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Navigations package. Also, I have defined a few CSS styles for the tree control wrapper class inside this style.css file. Now, I run this example using the command ng-serve. Look at the output page. The mailbox parent node is expanded initially, and other nodes and their corresponding subnodes are also displayed when we expand their parent nodes. Next, I will show you how to customize the tree nodes using a template. I want to display the number of new messages in the inbox and the total number of items in the spam and sent items. To do this, first, I add a count field to the existing TreeView data object with the appropriate value. Then, I plan to create a custom template to display the count in node text by defining the ng template tag with the template reference variable node template. Here, I add a few division and span elements with the class attribute. To display the tree node text, I assign the name field using a data parameter. Then, I assign this count field using a data parameter to show the count value in the TreeView node. I want to display this count in the TreeView node if the count field exists, so let me add a condition using ngif to check whether it does. If the count field exists in the data source objects, then this count will be displayed. Next, I define CSS class property and assign the class name custom TreeView to it. Now, I am going to define this custom TreeView CSS class inside this style file for customizing the tree node text and new message number in the inbox and the total items in the spam and sent items nodes. As you can see, the TreeView component shows the total number of items in the spam and sent items nodes and the number of new message in the inbox node. Next, I am going to show you how to display these counts using the badge component. To start using the Angular badge component, you need to install the Syncfusion Angular notifications package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-notifications --save. As I have already installed this package, I am skipping this step here. Then, I define class attribute and add the classes ebadge and ebadgePrimary to this span element where the count will be displayed. Next, I am going to define CSS for badge component, so I import notifications material theme in the style.css file. Look at the output page now. Inbox, spam and sent items badge counts are displayed. If I want to customize the nodes based on their levels, I set custom styles for each level of node using the CSS class property. As you know, I already defined the CSS class property for the TreeView component, so let me use this class to customize the node levels. First, I navigate to the style.css file. Then, I want to display the first level nodes in bold, so I add the classes and set the font weight to bold. Next, I add the color attribute with an appropriate color code inside these classes to display the second level nodes in blue. For the leaf nodes, I want to show them in a different font color and in italics, so I define the font style and color attributes with appropriate values. Looking at the TreeView component now, the parent nodes are shown bold, the second level node's text font is displayed in blue, and the leaf nodes are in italics. Next, I will show you how to change the expand and collapse icons. To add icons, first, I define a font face with a specific SRC path and name its font family, customize icon, so that I can start accessing the required font icons for this tree view at the application level. Then, for these class names, like custom tree view, elist item, and eicons, I set the defined font family name and set the appropriate content values to access the needed font icon. Look at the output page now. You can see the newly added icons for the expand and collapse icons. Finally, I will show you how to add icons and images to the TreeView nodes using the icon CSS and image URL properties. I want to show icons for the sales reports and marketing reports nodes, and images for the employee 1 and employee 2 nodes. First, I need to add two more fields, node icon and node image with appropriate values. Then, I assign these fields to the icon CSS and image URL properties. I define a few CSS styles for customizing the TreeView node icons and images. In the output, you can see where the TreeView component nodes are displayed with defined icons and images. In this video, we saw how to customize the Syncfusion Angular TreeView component using the template option. We saw how to change the expand and collapse icons and customize the TreeView nodes based on their levels. Finally, we saw how to add icons and images to the tree nodes. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.